NBA 2K21 Next Gen has launched, and man, I'm not gonna lie to you, I didn't know what to expect. It's a giant city, there's gonna be thousands of people in one server, I'm sure the lag is gonna be crazy. And my God, the experience playing on day one was some of the most brutal 2K you could have possibly imagined. Hey, we're gonna get into all the itty bitty news and drama, ladies and gentlemen. If y'all new to the channel, bro, we do daily uploads, and apparently now daily streams, is that what we're doing now? Drop a like, man, subscribe. Let's try and get the video to 30,000. I'll wait. All right, so I'm not gonna lie to you, man. First impression, city is grand. City is massive. There's a lot of things going on in the city. A lot of things. Agent, I wanna get a sleeve. Oh, you gotta head over to JT Sporting Goods near Northside City Knights Heights. Besides the point, there's everything everywhere and it takes a while to get used to. The experience before the game launched, the 2 days I played before the launch and it was just like other YouTubers in there, it was fine. Like there was very, I don't wanna say very little, but the latency wasn't as bad, but there was no choppiness at all. The servers, once everybody got on Xbox, were some of the most atrocious gameplay I've ever gotten a chance to experience in my life, guys. It felt like I was playing on 2 frames per second, and it didn't even feel like I was playing a video. It felt like I deadass was watching like a slideshow, and I would get a frame if I was lucky every once in a while. There was also issues of people joining a park and then joining the wrong park. So that's back in 2K now. That's been happening a decent amount on the Xbox for me. So I'm gonna give you guys just some of the community reaction because people had to react. For what it's worth, when the game was smooth, oh my God, you guys saw a giant smile on my face while I was playing these videos. It just feels so good to see something refreshing. The gameplay feels different. I don't know if it's better yet. It feels different, something new. But man, yesterday was a struggle. Aiden put out a tweet. He said, NBA 2K21 Next Gen is unplayable right now. The worst choppiness I've ever experienced on a video game. Can we please get this addressed to the dev team and fixed ASAP? I really want to stream. Aiden was telling me, I think it was Aiden that was telling me this. Who was it? It might've been Aiden. Where he was streaming and it was choppy as shit. And then Ronnie came in his stream. And then in the one game where Ronnie was there, it wasn't choppy anymore. So then Ronnie probably left thinking like, oh no, the service is fine. But they're bad, like Park After Dark bad. The only difference is it doesn't kick you from the games nearly as much on next gen. So you just get to experience the bad. You don't have to go to the menu this time. Hank the Tank put out a tweet saying, the porks, probably super laggy because we're in a massive GTA server with 4 parks. Massive, guys. The scale of this thing is massive. And if you don't get a skateboard or a quick way to move around, it's gonna take you forever to get to destinations. Where'd you guys load into? Oh, the opposite side of the map? Give me 3 minutes. I'm gonna skateboard over there while I do some tricks on the way there. I'm gonna ollie and grind on the rails. I'll say this though, in the name of convenience, the load times have been truly spectacular, guys. Just on simple things like jumping into your jump shot crater to change a jump shot, even though the jump shot crater is broken. Simple things. Loading into a park takes 1 second. Troy Dan said, hopefully the city lag goes away soon. That was real hard playing on 8 FPS. I was live with both Aiden and Troy Dan on stream yesterday, and Troy Dan just, he literally said he was having a headache from how bad it was. It felt worse playing than it looked. I have some gameplay recorded, it might go up on the channel. It doesn't look as bad as it feels. Does that make sense? But people across the board felt it. I did realize though, for those looking for a fix, when I went over to the West servers, because I play on East, it felt a lot better. But then when I went back on East, it felt better. I don't know how to explain it. The latency is off the charts horrible. That goes without saying, no matter which server you play on. But try and experiment going between East, West, maybe even go Europe, man. That deadass might be better than playing on the choppiness we played on last night. Power though went on Twitter to address a new issue everybody was having. He said this, Baluba, jump shot speed is glitched. Whatever speed you set your jump shot to for custom jump shots, it automatically decreases by 1 level, please fix. That's the jump shot glitch I've been trying to tell y'all about, bro. I can't get my quick jump shots. Now, what Power is talking about, that wasn't my experience. In my experience, no matter whether I put the jump shot on very quick or slow, no matter where I put it, when I saved it and I left, it defaulted to normal. So I can't change my jump shot speed, so I can't use the jump shot crater. So I most def responded saying, please, man, please this has to be addressed because right now I'm using straight Curry release and it's not nearly as good as my Trey Burke, Rudy Gay release. We know that to be the case, man. Badge Plug put out a tweet saying, so games are still playing at 10 frames. The jump shot crater release is glitched at 75%. And you can't make it to 100. If you do it, it just resets back. You can't hit Pro 3 because you rep up and then get an error code every time. This day one patch needs to come out ASAP. I know with the next gen console and everything new that's going on that there's gonna be issues, but the type of issues we've seen on next gen current first beautiful first day is unlike anything I've ever seen. And keep in mind, this is coming off the heels of the current gen launch, where on day one, it was probably the smoothest day one we've gotten in at least 5-6 years in 2K. So it went from the smoothest launch to one of the ugliest launches. And the reality is, it's getting in the way of people's enjoyment and experience. People are so excited picking up their consoles, paying and whatever it takes to get one of these things, then finding the game, and then just to get on the game and to be just playing on 2 frames per second. That's not the experience. And the worst part about it is we know that this is an easy fix. I did a video a couple years ago, I'll link in the description and put an end screen, where I literally flew to Virginia, where the 2K servers are at, just to see like how good the experience was. Guys, mind blowing. I swear, if you guys live in DC or like Virginia area, the type of beautiful server gameplay you guys probably have, because all of the East servers are Amazon servers, right? Anyway, besides the point, I learned on that trip though, that all it really takes is 2K to pay more money. The infrastructure already exists. It's not like they have to build something out to make this happen. So I'm hoping that 2K ends up doing that. From what I've heard, Rookieville servers are actually pretty good and there's not a lot of choppiness on there. But when you head over to the city is when it gets really bad. And so while all of that is going on, Ronnie is like doing this stuff on Twitter. Giveaway time, and then he posts like screenshots. I could imagine Ronnie going to the developers and he's like, guys, could you guys make me like 50 games? I wanna do a TikTok post. There's some small quality of life fixes that I think 2K needs to make. For example, when you hop on the threes court, now while you're waiting for your game, you can hoop around, which is so dope, by the way. But while you're hooping, your camera actually isn't facing the GOT next anymore, so you have no idea whether or not people are even getting ready to play on your court. And you can't check to see like, yo, is someone on that court? Maybe we should go to that court instead. Quality of life. You can't even see what the GOT next is. You should be able to like change the camera angle or something like that. There was an issue before the launch of the game, and I don't know if it's still persisting, where when you go to like JT Sporting Goods, for example, where it happened a lot, you try and purchase something, it would say purchase failed. You literally travel across the city to go to a store to spend your VC, and they would be like, we don't want your VC. And it's because the stores and the transactions just didn't work. And you know how much 2K likes money, bro, so. They got to, I can't, you could tell I'm not a good snapper personally. I didn't go to snapping school. You could tell they fixed that one ASAP because it hurt the pockets. And I haven't experienced it yet. So after day zero, I haven't experienced that glitch myself, so I'm assuming that one there got fixed. In terms of gameplay, there's a couple things of note. I didn't bother upgrading my driving layup because I was like, I'm gonna hit layups anyway, and my shot close. So when I was upgrading my attributes, I just did everything else, and then I realized that my player cannot make layups at all. Like, he's bricking wide open layups. So when I upgraded my layup from a 55 to a 70 next time I got an attribute upgrade, he started hitting everything. So I'm telling you guys right now, off rip to save your build. If you think it's okay to run around with a 50 close shot and driving layup, you will be absolutely miserable when this happens. Here we have Ticino playing some defense, and here is a big man with slasher takeover, by the way. And the amount of layups he's missing on decent releases, some of these. And as you can see, there's actually an interesting glitch. Look closely at the shot meter. Where, did you see it right there? I'm gonna run it back so you guys see it. When you look at the shot meter, it moves, and then when you let go of it, it snaps to the very end and gives you a very late release. I don't know why that glitch exists, but I noticed it when I was in Rookieville. And I actually turned off my layup timing. So, because that was the only fix I could imaginably think of, so I don't have to time my layups anymore. But considering this guy has takeover, and look, this one right here. That f***ing missed, guys. So I'm telling you, if you do not upgrade your layup, that is what your situation is gonna be looking like. I just went from a 55 to a 70, and now I hit all of those now. All the rolls he just missed, I hit those now. I used to never be able to hit those. I swear it was night and day difference. So just in case y'all think it's valid to run around with a 55 driving layup and close shot, bad idea. Everyone's kind of just been fascinated with the city because that's like the new big thing that 2K is doing. Of course, there's some changes to MyNBA and we have to wait for those guys to play the game to experience those. But Dom2K did let us know what's new on Play Now Online this year. Play Now Online is the exact same garbage. Okay, good. So nothing's new. And the sad reality is the reason there's nothing new is the top comment to that was, why would 2K dramatically change a mode that makes them no extra money? I think 2K is largely motivated by money, true, but also The City, for example, I don't think, now this is a prediction, I don't think The City is gonna make 2K nearly as much money as my team is, and my team is largely the same experience while The City is a brand new experience on next gen. So it's not entirely motivated by money at the same time. But what do you do with Play Now Online, man? How do you improve that game mode? People that still play Play Now are like old heads, man. And those people, man, you're not gonna change their mind. They're gonna buy the 2K and they're gonna play Play Now regardless of whether or not something has changed. Which is why you really don't see complaints about Play Now no matter how the same it is every single year. Oh look, Troy and I said the same thing. I just played games on Westside and didn't get any lag spikes in games. Wonder what is causing it. I was playing on Westside last night though and I got lag, Troy. We did have a lot of questions when it came to next gen, everything from dribble tiers to what attributes you did when you hit 99, do you get the +4? Like, we didn't really have any of those questions answered. Zach, developer at 2K, decided to help us answer some of those questions. He went on Twitter and he said this. If a badge has a requirement that you can hit when you reach 95 plus overall, i.e. when you get +1 to +4 on your attributes at 96, 97, 98, 99, then yes, you can unlock and equip that badge once each that over. What? Once you're, fuck, do I not know how to read? God damn it, guys, I just woke up, I'm sorry. If your overall dips, you don't lose the badge. That's good news. He followed up and said, example, corner specialist to Hall of Fame is an 88 three ball. If you have a 3-point rating of 87 after creating your player, you can unlock corner specialist at Hall of Fame at 96 overall because you're hitting 3-point rating received a 1+ boost for hitting 96. And is Zach verifying here that all you need to do is hit 99 one time, and even if you lose it, you can keep those badges? He did. If your overall dips, you don't lose the badge. So all you gotta do is hit 99 once this year. For badges, for attributes, you gotta keep it. Very interesting system, Zach Timmerman, NBA 2K developer, and Cyclones, Chiefs, Bulls, Cubs, Goonies producer. This is about the time, just based on historical standards here, where we're gonna get absolute radio silence until patch 1 drops, because there's gonna be a lot of frustrated people about the servers, and 2K's is gonna be like, let's disappear from the internet until we have something to say. I'm really hoping some day one patch drops, just some quick patch. I'm hoping the whole patch process got better with next gen. In previous years, it'd take 1 to 2 weeks for Xbox or PlayStation to approve a patch. But at the same time, we also don't want a Ubisoft to happen where a patch goes out and then it bricks everybody's console. Well, I'm recording this on the 11th, which means that in about 12 hours, everyone's gonna get their PlayStation 5s, and then the servers is gonna go crazy over there. So I'm getting mine as well. I'm gonna be playing the game on PlayStation 5 as well, so I'll let you guys know what that experience is like. Yo, if y'all new to the channel, man, we do this. I keep y'all posted. I drop funny videos from time to time. Drop a like, let's hit 30,000, subscribe to the channel. I'm also gonna do a stream later today, man, and a second channel upload. Link to that is also in the description. If y'all new, man, do the thing. I'm catch you guys in the next one. Videos on the screen. I'm out. Peace.